Hey guys, how's it going? This is David Kwan giving you a channel update, just talking about what's been up with me. And what's been up with me is that I've been really busy, especially this past week and maybe the previous week, but not kind of really, because I've talked about this before, but it's a juggling act for me. You know, being a graduate student, being a social work graduate student, means kind of like I have this field placement, you know, being an intern for 21 hours a week, and that takes so much precedence of my life. That takes so much priority in my life. It's insane. But then at the same time, I am a graduate student, so I had this schoolwork. So this balance between being an intern and being a student is one that I struggle with, the intern being like over here and student like not even, you know, I try to cram in what little readings that I can. But this past week has been extremely taxing on me, because it's midterm time. I had 3 midterm papers due this past Saturday, and then my final midterm paper due this Tuesday, which is today actually, or it's soon gonna be yesterday. But yeah, finally I handed it in. All my midterms for this semester are done. Oh man, all these midterm papers really just totally kicked my ass this semester. I think partly that's because, I haven't been in college in a long time. I just recently started graduate school, and the last time I was doing anything college-related was 3 years ago. You know, I graduated with my bachelor's over 3 years ago. So I'm still kind of just adjusting to college. And I've been really kind of procrastinating as well in some respects. You know, I come home, and I should be reading and doing college work, being more productive, but then I come home being so tired from working and you know, my internship, that I just kind of kick back, and that's where the problem has been, that I just kick back at home, but then, you know, when I'm not home, I'm at work or at my internship, so, like, trying to squeeze time to do this was outside of home, yeah, I haven't been very smart, that's needless to say. So can't be procrastinating. The balance, I think, could exist. It just means that I will have no free time whatsoever. I really have to just push myself to always be working and always be productive to make that balance work for me. And it's weird because, you know, when I was working at a homeless shelter, I definitely did not have that kind of balance. You know, I was working so many hours a week. It was ridiculous how many hours a week, and I was getting fatigued and stuff, but like it was something that I could push myself to doing. But I kind of broke down this semester, or just starting graduate school. For example, like I broke down like pretty much today. You know, I had this paper due. I finished it like 5 in the morning, and I'm just like, I have to go to my internship in the morning, but like I couldn't. So today I actually didn't go to my internship. So that's my first time kind of, you know, taking a personal day, for my internship for this semester, for this year. Hopefully, we do get 3 personal days, as an intern per year, or per semester. I think it's per year actually, per year. Yeah. So I'm hoping not to use them at all, but I ended up using it today because it was too much for me. And I'm kind of disappointed in myself, you know, because it's just like, really, just midterm papers is all it really took to have me break down in that. I'm not sick or anything, but yeah. But now it's done and over with. It's definitely been super taxing. I do want to talk about, like, some of the midterm assignments. One was really frustrating. So my diversity course, so this course name is Diversity, Racism, Oppression, and Privilege. If you put an acronym, that's DROP. So this is my DROP course, right? Diversity, Racism, Oppression, and Privilege. And this is a class where we talk about that kind of stuff, you know, racism, classism, sexism, sexual orientation discrimination, white privilege. It's a very heavy-handed class, right? Can get pretty emotional sometimes. You know, it's a very small setting class. But the midterm assignment, I just did not like this at all. The biggest challenge that I had with it is the page limit. So I can't write, I wasn't able to write more than 5 pages. And that, for me, is very hard. I'm a very wordy person, talking-wise, as you could see, and writing as well. And especially when you have a in drop course. The topics are so heavy-handed. Racism, for one, like, I could write for hours and, I mean, pages and pages on that, but having just 5 pages. But it's 5 pages, and the requirements for this paper is I have to interview 2 people at my internship, and so I have to incorporate that interview into this paper. And the interview is about the organization, you know, that I interned for. You know, the organization's history, organization's mission, structure, funding, how the funding impacts the organization's way it does things. And so I interviewed the site director, and I interviewed my supervisor, the site supervisor. And somehow also I asked some questions to my interview, to the site supervisor about diversity in the agency and how, you know, that how she thinks the agency is doing in regards to diversity, what could be improved, and trying to incorporate that back into the paper, right? So that's one aspect of it. But I also have to do a power analysis of the agency. You know, what kind of power is inside, what are the power dynamics in this agency? Who has power? How is power shared? I had to do a power analysis, and that's a pretty complicated thing. I could only do one paragraph on that because of the page limit. So, you know, most of the paper I was talking about the agency. But then another kicker is that I have to also incorporate 5 different classroom readings. So 5 articles or 5, you know, excerpts from books to talk about the diversity issue, the power analysis. All this, there's so many things to talk about, and I'm given 5 pages to do so, and so it's gotten really condensed in there, and I really feel like I did a good job of that. Just one paragraph I had on power analysis, that's a big problem, you know. My midterm for the human behavior in environment, I think that's the name of it, the course, human behavior environment, one, social environment, something like that. That's a course where we talk about kind of theories that social workers use, you know, psychodynamic theory, psychoanalytic theory, learning theory, object relations, ego psychology, all those kind of things. That's the pretty much meat of the course. The midterm paper is really interesting. My professor assigned us to read this excerpt from a New York Times article. And this New York Times article talks about Fernando, who is this 16-year-old kid who leads a life of crime, escaped from like a correctional institution, and is currently selling drugs and things like that. And we analyzed this person, and our paper assignment was pretty much just asking about, well, you know, what stage is he in, psychosexual stage? You know, what is his attachment like? So asking about to analyze, do psychosocial pretty much on Fernando. And it was a fun assignment. Really challenging, though. I think I did spend so much time reading about it that I didn't end up having enough time to write about it. So it ended up being 6 pages long, but it really should have been 8 pages. So I didn't get enough time to finish it. So it's kind of incomplete, and I ended up handing it a little bit incomplete. So I don't know. The best I can receive on this paper, I'm not sure. I'll probably end up getting a C or a B-, a B if I'm lucky. I don't think so. Didn't really do so well, but this paper really kicked my ass and my classmates' asses. We just got our asses handed to us with this paper. Because after we handed it in, in that classroom period, we discussed about Fernando. And nobody had, you know, almost all of us pretty much had most of that paper wrong. We were so wrong about our analysis of Fernando. And it's just like, wow, if we're graded on how we're correct we are in our assessment, all of us just totally bombed that. And what I handed in today, earlier today, was for my social welfare programs and policy course. And this was an interesting assignment. It pretty much was, I was asked to discuss how the nature of social welfare programs and policies. You know, is it universally provisional? Is it selective? Is it on a, you know, what is the benefit of a federal program versus like federalism? What is the benefit of private versus public relief? Things like that. And I had to use 5 different New York Times articles at least to talk about different examples and discussion points. So it was actually a really interesting and challenging paper to do. That I feel the most confident about, except, like, I don't know, I wish I had more time to read more stuff and to rewrite, because it could have turned out better. At this point, it just kind of starts out pretty strong, and then, like, the ending part's kind of, I don't think I'll get an A. It's just not going to happen. Best case scenario for that paper is probably going to be B+, but I expect it to be more B- range, or B. But, yeah, that's... Midterms are over. Thank goodness. Oh, it's been crazy. It's been crazy. But, fortunately... Well, no. Oh, my gosh. I now have finals to worry about. And that's going to be due in a month. So, again, going to have to... Yeah, being a college student, man, it really sucks sometimes.